No one's I've never failed at it either. Right. So like let's do it.
Yeah. Exactly. Like mostly, you know, when you're a kid, it's like, I want to do this. Okay, go ahead. Your parents support you. Mm-hmm. You wanna play softball or something. And they're like, okay, great, let's do it and whatever. And you're just out there being fearless.
Mm-hmm.
But then when you get older and you get a lot of no, you get a lot of rejection, that's when the fear set in.
Yep.
So I had to in this business you do with a lot of rejection, of course, because you get a lot of no's before you get your few yeses and your big yeses. Thank you. But I had to learn that, hey, you know what? If I believe it, then it's not. One thing I used to say is when breakdowns would come out, they would say, submit star names only or name talent only.
Mm-hmm.
And that was a big one for me because I'm like, oh, well, I'm not a name. Well, I'm not a name, so I'm not going to get that. Well, I'm not a name. Now, I know what that means. It's a household name that they want. A person
right.
with a, now, a person with a bigger following is what they want when they say name talent only. But I had to realize, wow, I was calling myself a nobody. Right. I was saying, I'm not a name. Mm-hmm. I'm not a name. I'm not a name. So guess what? I never got those.
Yeah. Right.
But when I stopped, when I realized that and stopped speaking that over me, then I went into the Tyler Perry audition like, okay, let me go ahead and book this. I'm ready. Mm-hmm. And then I booked it.
Right.
But it was a changing of my mindset that allowed me to really be able to flourish and grow in life, period.
That's very true.
Yeah.
I love that.
All right. All right. So guys, let's go ahead and get into our topics.
Topics. Hot topics.
News and noteworthy. The shiznit.
So here in Southern California, we had a school shooting.
Oh, good God.
I'm sorry to laugh. We'll go finish.
What happened?
Because it was just weird. The whole shooting was weird.
Right. Because it actually isn't a school shooting like how...
Your typical that you would think.
Right. It wasn't really a school shooting, but for lack of a better term, it was a school...
And when it first
broke, everybody thought, you know, everybody just thought it was, you know, a typical school shooting.
Mm-hmm.
So what happened was there's a 12...
I hate that phrase, typical school shooting.
The fact that we have to say it that way. No,
all I thought about was massacre. Yeah. I swear to God. Yeah. I was like, oh my God, this was not a massacre. And that's all people was like, it's a massacre.
Sorry, Dino.
Yeah, it's okay. So a 12-year-old girl, a middle school girl, brought a gun to school. And, well, the first reports that came out was, oh, school shooting, a 12-year-old girl, whatever. So people had visions of, you know, a 12-year-old girl just spraying down her classmates and teachers and whatnot.
Right.
But come to find out, that's not what happened. She did bring a semi-automatic weapon to school, and she had it in her backpack. Now from here on, the story splits into two different versions. And in both versions, it's still, the outcome is the same. It's an accident. So not exactly sure which version is true. But one version I read says that there's some girls were playing with it, thought it was a toy. Which I totally understand because way back when I was in junior high school, before school shootings were commonplace, a guy brought a gun to school, and I thought the exact same thing. I thought it was a toy. I even held the gun.
Wow.
And thought it was a toy. But I had sense enough not to pull the trigger because even if it's a, you know, if there's a chance that it's real, you don't pull the trigger.
Right.
But yeah, he handed me a loaded gun and was like, you know, because he was being bullied.
Mm.
You know, he ended up getting caught with it and expelled and all this big old thing. But he didn't actually shoot anyone. Thank God for that. Anyway, so I totally understand them thinking that it's a toy.
Mm-hmm.
And it went off. That's one story. Another story is that, or another version of the story is that the girl had it in her backpack and she dropped the backpack and then the gun went off. So in either case, it was an accident. The police are confident that it was an accident and it was not an intentional shooting. And in either case, five people ended up getting wounded from that one gunshot. Now, you ask yourself, how did five people get, is like a magic bullet? No, what happened was two people were shot. It was a ricochet off one guy's temple and hit another girl's wrist. The other three people were wounded by glass.
Yeah,
that was caused by the bullet. They weren't actually wounded by the bullet. So when any time you know, you get casualties from an incident, they list all of them.
Right.
You know. So,
of course.
But the first couple stories I read, they didn't break it down. They just say five people, you know, injured because of this shooting. I'm like, how the fuck? What kind of bullet? Like what? Like two? I get, but. Five?
Right.
Like, what kind of, like, ricochet rabbit? Ping, 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 ping.
But no, it's in an elementary school. Those are small hallways for small people.
Mm-hmm.
Middle school.
But still, you know, lockers, metal.
But do we know her intention for bringing the gun to school?
The last time I checked in the story, we weren't getting anything as far as intent. I'm guessing bullies. I'm pretty sure. You know, I mean, like, what else? Mm. You know, it could be, I'm guessing. Also, I don't guns know, are, but I'm thinking bullies.
Guns
you know.
Are also glorified in our culture, and like you see a gun, that's cool. So
yeah, that's true. She could have just been kind of looking.
Yeah, but typically kids nowadays, when they bring guns to school, it's generally as a response to bullying.
Like you know, since I don't have kids,
generally. Didn't you pass the gun off though to another kid?
That's a whole nother story.
Yeah, I don't know.
Now that's the third version.
Yeah, exactly. Wow. Exactly. Yeah. I don't know where that's coming from. I've never heard that part. So.
See, but I was always under the impression that these schools had these, at least what you would hear in the media, like these zero tolerances. Mm. You can't even bring like a little army man with a gun to school. So that's what was, for me, is like the disconnect of like, Well,
it is against the rules, but people break rules.
The truth that, but I'm just sort of saying, I felt like that's... Again, what I would get from the media right now is, or for the last several years, is like the idea of any kind of gun in a school, plastic, even a tiny one, is like not tolerated.
It's not.
So, like that.
But they have to know about it to, if you know, they have to know that somebody's doing it. Somebody sneaks something in, you know, it's not tolerated. So, I mean, she was arrested.
Right.
So clearly it's not tolerated.
Right. But I, like, I just, again, but that would be such a big deal then for a child. It's that much more of a big deal for a child to bring a gun to school. You're, I'm amening your point.
Right.
It must be bullying or something. It has to be a big deal.
Oh, I get, okay. I see where you're going. Yeah. Yeah. To go that far.
Right.
We were
right.
So,
they thought
we were
it
so
was
worried.
Fake.
We were so worried about where you were going with
yeah,
that.
Yeah, I was like,
I'm like,
everybody's face is like, what is happening with what he's saying?
Yeah. Like,
no, I'm just wrapping my brain.
I get it now, but yeah, first it was like, what? But yeah, you know, this is the thing. And
do we have to have metal detectors at every school now?
This you know, just... a lot of people are, you know, that's happening. But see, this is what I think. Okay. I think we need to redirect our energy towards this problem. And I'm not just saying, you know, everybody, oh, Dino's a gun guy, whatever. Yes, I am a gun guy, but that's you know, neither here nor there. I believe my way would be much more effective. So instead of just like making all the gun laws super strict and super restrictive and all that kind of stuff over, yeah, they do need to be tightened up in a lot of places. California, New York, New Jersey really aren't on that list, but whatever. What would be more effective, in my opinion, would be if they were to crack down on the parents of the... Now, because 99% of the time, these kids and these shootings and things like that, they get a gun from home, right? Which means the parent isn't doing their job and making sure that the house and the gun, whatever, locked up safely and out of reach and out of the control or the touch of the children. So I feel like if they were to crack down on the parents and they were starting to make examples of these parents, then these other parents who are careless and lazy about, you know, how they keep their firearms at home will stop doing that. As opposed to just saying, oh, okay, well, you know, we have, you can have a lower magazine capacity, or you could, all that stuff doesn't address the problem that your kid got their hands on your gun. But that's the problem.
But see, but how do you do that? Because you'd have to legislate, or you have to make rules about people's personal homes and their parenting skills.
No, it's not.
You're saying just like punish the people. So you make the law so that if you become one of the people whose children take a gun from the home, then you have to suffer. I don't understand how you can do that. You can do that.
Why not?
You can't tell people how to.
Yes, you can. As a matter of fact, they already have, like, before they sell guns, like, you have to have a lock, you have to show the lock, or you have to buy the lock at the time of purchase, different things like that. There's already certain rules or whatever the way, you know, that apply to gun safety. So if this happens...
So you, and you're a legal gun owner, though, you have to tell your child's school that you have a gun?
No. I'm saying that if... take this example. This girl brought a gun to school. Find out where the girl brought the gun from. If she finds out she got it, if you find out she got it from home, find out how she got it from home. Now, if the child supersedes all of the safeties and she steals the key and then unlocks it, or she, you know, finds the combination to your safe and does it, like, then okay, then you're off the hook. But if the child says, I went in my daddy's drawer and got his gun and I took it to school, then that parent needs to be punished.
Okay, again, but see, that's post that. So now you're saying, like, after something bad's happened, we treat these people harshly. But that doesn't prevent future
situations. Yes, it does.
And you know,
it's called deterrent.
Did you know that, like, if your child misses, like, too many days of school, the parent can go to jail or be given a ticket? So it would kind of be like the same thing. If your child does something at school...
or like crime in crime period. We punish people after they commit a crime, not before they commit
it. That's true too. Mm-hmm.
That's that if you make that a crime and then they commit that crime, then after a fact they are punished, and then people as a result, if the word gets out, they're like, "Oh, I better lock my shit." Now there's no penalty. Like, okay, yes, a child or a person could end up injured. That's bad, and that should be enough for a responsible person to take precautions, but evidently it's not because it doesn't. All right. Now they're saying, oh, this is going to cost me, you know, $5,000 and 6 months in jail or a year in jail, whatever it is.
Some type of reaper, yeah.
Yeah, something. On top, then I'm going to go ahead and put this lock on and make sure this little kid can't get into this shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm going to go that extra mile so that this doesn't come back on me.
Okay. Because as a parent, you're responsible for your kids until they're 18 anyway. You pay child support to the 18.
Exactly.
You miss a lot of days in school or whatever till they're whatever, age 18. You're responsible. So if a gun, you know, I definitely understand what he's saying.
Yeah, the
there
child
needs to be some
the
kind of repercussion.
Gun, they should be.
Absolutely.
And then that way, you punish people who deserve to be punished, and you're not infringing on other people's rights to protect their home. And Pip doesn't have a kid. Pip doesn't have a wife. Pip doesn't have a dog. Pip could, you know, leave his gun on the breakfast table if he wanted to. That should be Pip's business and his priority and his prerogative. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But so we shouldn't make laws that's going to restrict everybody from protecting themselves or only if they choose to do that just because there's people at home who are careless. Let's punish the careless people and stop making all these super strict gun laws and making it hard. Because all you're doing is making it harder on law-abiding citizens. Because guess what? Criminals don't give a fuck about your laws. They don't care about magazine capacity and micro-stamping and all these laws. They don't care about that shit. They break laws, so they don't follow them anyway. Right. So all you're doing is making it harder on the law-abiding citizens.
Yeah.
I hear what you're saying, and I definitely agree that something should be done. However, I don't know how that could be pulled off. And I know we're just talking, right? I get it. But it kind of goes back to the sexual misconduct that was happening all over Hollywood. Some people were doing various different levels of it. Mm-hmm. Matt Damon came out and he spoke about, like, everybody, you know, there's different levels to it. If I compliment you, that may be a little bit disrespectful. That's different from me actually touching you. Mm-hmm. So I shouldn't get punished as severely as you should be punished, right? Because your crime was harsher than mine.
Right.
It's like, there's no bigger sin kind of thing. Mm-hmm. And so not unfortunately, but everyone, you know, lives under the blanket of it's wrong, no, you're punished.
Right.
So even with this, although I get and understand, that's a good idea. I think a parent should be responsible if their child takes the gun out of their home because they're not responsible enough to keep it locked up like it should be, even away from your child. What if she was just playing with it and it went off and it killed her?
Right.
You know what I mean? A plethora of things could happen. There's a multitude of things that needs to happen for that.
Exactly.
However, I don't know that that's something that would be able, that they can then differentiate between the two without making it a blanket thing for everyone.
Well,
I think I do.
I do, I think. And I think you, it's a tie between what you guys were saying and what I was trying to say earlier.
It's tying it together.
Yeah.
Like, I was trying to fathom, like, how do you make a law that is preemptive of something like that? But what you're saying is, the law is, if your gun is used or brought into a school, you are subject to...
It's not about school. It's about safety, gun safety. And if anybody who's not the registered owner of that gun just walks into your house and can get the gun because it's not locked away and does something with it, then you should be held responsible for it.
Okay.
It's not about the school. That's after the fact. Because like Taja said, what if it happens in the home? What if it happens next door, on the playground?
Well, let me finish my law resolution.
Okay.
Dear Congress, this law shall be...
Pip, you have the floor.
Thank you.
The filibuster. Mr.
Reclaiming his time.
Mr. Smith goes to Washington.
Reclaiming his time.
I would like to yield 1 minute.
This is C-SPAN on the Red Rock Podcast Network.
No, so like public. This basically is like a law. Like if your gun is used in another crime or but in this particular case that we're talking about is being a gun being brought into the school.
Mm-hmm.
So if your gun is being brought into a school, then you are subject to these fines and blah 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 blah.
Yeah. Right.
And that way that you're saying that would be a deterrent because most people do not want that to happen.
Right.
Right.
So yeah, I'm with you. I was just trying to like figure out how do we get there.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is that also sort of what you're saying? Like, that's tricky.
I think we could do that. Yeah,
with that
I already
law.
Agree with that point.
But she,
my other, yeah. go ahead.
No, I think
we'll get
that
you
she,
in there. What I'm saying.
I think why don't you tell us what you're saying?
I know. No, I think that it would be very hard. It would have to take a lot of investigation to really determine how much fault, how much fine, how much penalty the person would have, because it's not them that's giving out the gun. So the